I'm Christine Hernandez. I'm the livestock specialist here at Heifer Ranch. Thank you for joining us for this video series of how we raise 20,000 birds on pasture. So we will show you how we set up our brooder to receiving chicks to our daily pasture chores and bring you to this end product of being finished with our poultry for the season. So this is our brooder that we use for our chicks. So you need a nice, clean, warm space, like a little chick nursery for when your chicks first arrive at your farm. And so this is the design that we settled on to have here at Heifer Ranch. It is 30 by 100. We have automatic water lines and automatic feed lines, as well as feeders and waters that we'll set out when the chicks first get here. But probably the most important thing is going to be the heat. And we have 6 of these brooder hoods that we can control with a control panel. And so it's really important that you keep your chicks to the proper temperature. So when your chicks first get here, you want it to be between 90 and 95 degrees. They will be super cute and full of soft yellow fur, pretty much. And so over time, they'll lose that and they'll get in their colored or their adult feathers. And so with that, you will control the temperature and start decreasing it over time so that when it's time for them to go from the brooder out to pasture, they're going to be used to that temperature that they'll be exposed to outside. So this is the record sheet that we use for all of our chicken batches. It starts here when they first arrive at the ranch. And the important information that we keep track of are the number of mortalities that we have, the number of bags of shavings that we put down on the floor so that we can use that to know how much our batch costs at the end of the season, and then how much feed that we put out each day. And so we have a column for each day of the week and then also for each chore time. So our morning chore time and our evening chore time. And so this starts with them when they get here in the brooder, and then it also goes out to pasture with them. And when they're out in pasture, we just keep track of the number of mortalities and how much feed we put out each chore time. This is the water system that we set out for when the chicks first get here. So it's just a simple 1 gallon water that you can pick up from your local co-op or feed store. We fill this with warm water, and then we also put a handful of sugar in that water so it dissolves. We want the chicks to get here and to get water with some sugar in it so that it helps boost their energy so they're up drinking water and eating food when they first arrive. We also have a water line in our brooder, and these are just nipple waters. So when the chicks get curious, they'll come up and they'll peck at this metal tip and a droplet of water will come out, and we can raise and lower this to the height of the chicken. So as the chickens grow in the brooder, we can just simply raise it with this toggle. And then that helps keep the floors clean in the brooder. We don't have any water spillage or anything like that. So these are the shavings that we use for our brooder. We get them from TLC, which is in Centerville, Arkansas. We buy a truckload at a time, and we get full pallets. I believe there's 35 bags of shavings per pallet. That way we have this space in our brooder where we can store 2 pallets of shavings at a time. So the shavings are already in here, and it's more efficient for us just to grab a bag and put it down on the floor. We like these shavings. I believe they are 6 cubic feet once you open them up, but they're shrink wrapped, so they're nice and small and light. And we like the shavings that have the bigger chips in there. It takes less bags to cover the space. And then with these bigger ones, the chicks are less likely to try to consume them. So previously we used shavings that were really fine, and chicks try to eat that instead of the grain. So these are the feeders that we put out before the chicks arrive. They're called turbo feeders. They just come in 2 pieces, and they simply, one sits on top of the other, and then we fill it with some feed. And we use these feeders until they are empty, which usually lasts them a couple of days. And then we move to our larger red feeders, and then our feed line, which you can see behind me. But the feed falls down here. nicely. It's nice and low to the ground so the chicks can easily get to it. And they're less likely to get shavings in here with their feed the way that this system is set up. We want the chicks, when they first arrive, it's really important for them to get to food and water as soon as possible. So we like to put our feeders out and our waters out so no matter where the chicks go, they're going to turn around and either run into feed or water. So these are the large feeders that we use. We introduce them to the chicks when they first get here, and then they will be using the same feeders throughout their 7 weeks that they're here at the ranch. They will hold 30 pounds of feed in there. And so what we like about these is that you adjust them to the height. So when the chicks first get here, it's nice and low into the ground so they can just reach over and get their feed. But as the chicks are growing in the brooder and out in pasture, we have it set up so that we can just move this S-hook up the chain, and that adjusts the height so that it is at the proper feeding height for the chicks throughout their life. So with these feeders, the feed space is a little bit bigger than with those turbo feeders we already saw. And so the chicks are more likely to get shavings in here and to actually climb up in here and eat their feed. So with our chores, we go around and make sure that we get out any shavings that are in here. And then at the end of each batch of chickens, we also bring these up and we clean them and we sanitize them so that they're ready to use for the next batch of chickens. So 1,600 chicks just arrived here at Heifer Ranch. You can see that they arrive in these blue crates. There'll be roughly 100 chicks per crate. When they get here, we bring them all inside and shut the door so we can keep it as warm as possible in here for them. And then our job is we just take each chick and we dip its beak in the sugar water we talked about earlier, and then we place it over by its food. So now it's had water with some sugar, and now it can go ahead and get right to eating and wandering around with its other chick friends. So we get our chicks from a local hatchery here in Arkansas. So these were actually hatched this morning and picked up by our driver and delivered here to us just a few hours away. You can also receive chicks through the postal service. They'll be delivered right to your local post office. That will take a few days for them to get to you. But what you're looking for when your chicks arrive is exactly what these chicks are doing. They're drinking, they're eating, they're being active, they're already scratching at the shavings and things like that. So those look like some very good, healthy chicks. So we are back in our brooder with our batch of 1,600 birds. They are roughly 2 weeks of age right now. And we have just been keeping a close eye on them, making sure that they are comfortable in their environment and they have clean feed and clean water on a daily basis. They will be going out to pasture here in about 5 days. So today I'm just going to walk you through our daily brooder chores. The first thing we do is that we will come inside and we will walk amongst our flock. We are looking for anyone that isn't thriving, so maybe isn't able to walk very well, is a lot smaller than everyone else, if there's any mortalities. So we'll just do a quick overview of that every time we come in our brooder. Then we will go ahead and make sure that our water heights are at the proper height for the birds. As you can see here with our water line, you want the chick to just have to raise her head a little bit to reach those nipples and to peck at that. We need to make sure that the water heights are suitable for everyone in our flock. Some birds are going to be bigger than others, so we need to make sure that we adjust the heights for them as they're growing. Thirdly, will be our feeders. So our main red feeder line, you can see the chicks have to sort of jump up to get in there. We do that so that when the chicks are scratching around, which you can see a lot of them doing now, that's their natural behavior. We want them to be able to exhibit that. They're scratching, looking for bugs, looking for spilt feed, anything like that. Is that when they scratch around the feeders, we want them to be high enough that they won't get shavings into their feed. Otherwise, that would just be another chore on us to clean the shavings out of those feeders. So the height that those are at right now are the perfect height for birds this age.
which these birds are around 2 weeks old. And then the second feeders would be these red hanging feeders. We incorporate these in our brooder from day one because these are the red feeders that they'll use out in the schooner. So we want them to already be accustomed to using them and to be familiar with them. We adjust the height of these with every chore time in the morning and in the afternoon. We want the pan of the feeder to be at the chicken's shoulders. So you can see where their neck and their body meet together. That's where we want this pan to be. We want the chick to just have to reach over slightly to get feed. If it's too low, the chicks will stand in it and kick shavings in there. We'll have to clean those out. Too high and all the chicks won't be able to get to it, or they'll have to jump up here in order to get feed. So we just adjust that with a simple S hook and chains hanging from the rafters. We will fill these with our bucketed feed during every chore time, where our main feed line going down the middle of our brooder is actually fed through a hopper system connected to our drain bins. So that just automatically fills itself. And then at the end of chores, we will also go through and we'll put down more shavings. We want our floor to be nicely covered so that we're covering any large manure spots. And that usually happens around the feeders where the chickens are hanging out a lot. And then along the water line as well, we'll cover up any spilt water or anything like that with our shavings to make sure our floor stays nice and clean. And then as these chickens are growing older, they're losing their yellow fluff that they showed up with, and they're actually getting these white feathers that you can see on them. And so after their first week in the brooder, we're going to start changing the temperature inside. So we're going to start gradually decreasing the temperature so that the birds will get acclimated to the outdoor temperature, so they're ready to be exposed to that when we put them out on pasture around 2.5 to 3 weeks of age. And one way we do that is actually with our brooder ends. We have two garage doors on each end. And so we just simply took a hog panel, the length of the garage door, we zip tied some chicken wire onto that. You can use screen or any other material you have laying around. We connected that to the hog panel so that we can open up those garage doors, let some air flow, let the outside temperature come inside, and then the chicks can't get out of the brooder and no predators can come into the brooder. We do close those doors every evening just as a precaution so that things don't try to get in here to our chickens. So if you're working on a smaller scale or smaller batches of chickens than we are here, and you don't have quite the automatic system that we have, you will still be changing their water twice a day, making sure that they have the fresh water, checking their feed, probably filling feeders more like this, making sure that there's no shavings or manure in that feed so the chicks can get the fresh feed as much as possible. And then you also have the option to not put down fresh shavings every day. Some people choose to do like the deep bedding method, where they just put a few inches of shavings when their chicks first arrive, and then they don't refresh those until the next batch is coming. Those are just different preferences, and you do whatever works best for you and your farming method. So I just wanted to introduce you to our prairie schooner. So this is the structure that we have out on pasture that we raise our birds in once they leave the brooder. So this is a 20 by 40 metal structure. You can buy the kits and assemble them yourselves. So before you put your chicks out to pasture, you need to make sure that you have a plan in place for where you're going to be moving your structures. If you're using a structure this large or anything smaller, you still need to make sure that the pasture you're using has a nice terrain without any creeks or big ditches going through it. You need to make sure to place your structures far enough apart so that if you have to turn them around and start coming back in the other direction, the chickens aren't going over places that they've already traveled. So this is just one of our schooners that we're getting ready to put our batch of 1600 birds out. You can see in there that we are using the same large red feeders from our brooder. We use the same ones out on pasture, so the chicks are already accustomed to eating out of them. We have little giant red water bowls and the water system we've made ourselves, which we can see more once the chicks are in there. The schooner is covered with a nice thick tarp. It's a billboard tarp, and the sides can be rolled down and rolled up so that you can adjust them for the weather. So if it's raining, we'll roll the sides down. If it's a nice sunny day, we'll roll them up. The front and the back of our schooners is a piece of wood, and then the bottom of it, we have screwed on the vinyl bathroom baseboard material. And so that gives the front and the back of our schooner the ability to go with the terrain of our pasture nicely. And then we can also put other things in there so the chicks don't get out of the schooner. So our schooners are covered in PVC coated chicken wire, which is just a little bit more sturdier than your regular plain metal chicken wire. And then on top of that, we also have some metal mesh wiring just as a stronger structure to keep predators, local dogs or anything like that, getting into our schooner and potentially getting our chickens. We chose this pasture here to run this batch of chickens on. We've never ran chickens on this pasture before, but looking at soil tests, this pasture needs some fertility. So we will be running our 1600 birds over this pasture without having to go over this land again until next year. So this structure is 20 by 40, and so we will be able to fit 500 to 550 birds in here at one time. When we put the chicks out here, they'll be roughly 2.5 weeks old, and a lot of that will depend on the weather. If it's going to be some pretty nasty weather, we'll hold the chicks in the brooder for a little bit longer so it's nicer outside when the chicks come out here. We will move this schooner forward one full space to fresh grass every single day. We choose to do that in the morning. And the way we do that is with a metal cable connected to either skid of the schooner, and we just connect this to a tractor and move it forward. One person is in the back of the schooner helping the chicks move forward, and the chicks learn very quickly that when the tractor is here and when we're here, then that means that they get fresh grass and they automatically come to the front of the schooner and they try to be the first ones to get the bugs. So this is the hose that we connect to our main water line with just a quick release, and the water will go into our homemade water system. We like the hose intake to be at the back of our schooner, so in the opposite direction that we're moving. That way the hose stays out of the way and the potential for running any parts or pieces over is non-existent. So today is graduation day for our chickens in the brooder. They are 3 weeks old today, so we are going to crate them up and take them out to the schooner, and they'll be on pasture for the next few weeks until they're ready to go to processing. So we're gonna show you how we do that with our chickens. The first is we will set up a smaller alleyway within the brooder so that we can walk and herd the chickens into the smaller section. And then we will load them into crates from there. It's less stressful on the chickens if they're in a smaller place. It's quicker and more efficient for us instead of having to walk around the rest of the brooder to get them and put them in crates. So we use our larger yellow crates to make the smaller alley. You can use anything else that you have there on your farm to do that. But we don't put the smaller chickens into those crates. We actually use these smaller game bird crates. We purchased them from 3T Products. I believe they're out of Minnesota. What we really like about these is that the floor of the crate is solid, and there's actually a little bit of texture on there that helps keep the chicks from slipping around in there. It prevents them from getting their claws through the bigger holes that are on the yellow crates. It's easier for one person to carry this with 15 to 18 birds in it rather than the awkwardness of the larger yellow crates. This crate also has two different types of doors. The first door is a hinge door, and that's how we put the chicks in and out, and I'll demonstrate that here in a little bit. The second door is a hinge door. We don't use that one as often, but it's still there to use if you'd like. Our first schooner full of chicks. There's a little over 500 chicks in here. So when we bring the crate full of 15 chicks in here, we set that crate on the ground. We slightly tip it back so you can flip that hinge door open, and then you can just gently tilt your crate forward so that the chicks will kind of slide and walk out of that crate. It's always important to check inside your crate and make sure there wasn't a chick hanging on in there. What we have right now is, this is our last batch of the year, so it's a little chilly out here. So we went ahead and put some hay around the edges of the inside of the schooner so that they can get inside there and just help keep them a little bit warmer tonight. The first thing we did when we brought this schooner out here is to make sure that there's no places for the chicks to get out of. So we made sure all of our end boards were in place properly, that there weren't any holes or ditches that the schooner were over top of. If that happens, we can fill them with hay, or we have some tarps or some shavings bags that we use in the brooder just to kind of fill those holes to keep the chicks inside and not allow them to get outside. It's important when you bring the red feeders down here that they're still at the proper height. Right at their shoulder length. We have always noticed that the first day the chicks come out to pasture, their feed intake increases a lot. And we want to prevent them from scratching any of that out. All of our schooners are also equipped with 4 T-posts that are hanging inside, as well as a big tarp. And they serve the purpose if there's a big storm coming in or high winds. The T-posts are already out here in the schooners. We can just grab a T-post driver so we can stake down the schooners, and then a tarp in case we need to put that over either of the ends if there's a lot of rain or wind coming through, just as extra protection for the chicks. So as you can see, the chicks have immediately started going to the grass, scratching in it, eating it, looking for some bugs. That is their natural behavior, and so we love to watch them and to see them start doing that right away. So we have every schooner also equipped with just a simple water fix-it kit. There's everything in there that you would need to either fix a leaking waterer or a leaking hose or anything like that. We like every schooner to have the water kit, the schooner, or the T-post and the tarps, so that you're not running around having to search for these things when you really need it. It's more efficient for it just to already be in each schooner. Every schooner also has a scrub brush, so we clean out the waterers every day, and it's just a simple scrub brush to make sure that we get any spilled feed or grime or anything like that out of the waters to make sure the chicks have fresh water every day. Some of the things that we include in our water fix-it kit is a box cutter. So if a hose needs a new end, it has a puncture in it, we can simply cut it and replace it with a female or male hose end. We always have extra rubber washers, some Teflon tape, a screwdriver that can go from Phillips to flathead, and that helps fix the water clamps, tighten those down. And then all the red little giant water bowls, we just buy extra bicycle valve cores, and then the little tool to re-put those in. They just get old and have to be replaced every so often. So this is Firewood and Ross, our livestock guardian dogs. This is the structure that we house them in at nighttime, and it's just one of our old chicken hoop houses. We upgraded to one of the schooners you see behind there. So we let our dogs out during the day to roam around, interact with the chickens and things like that. They are still a little young, so we lock them up at nighttime just until they get a little bit more mature. But they have food and fresh water in there. This gets moved every day with chores to also give them fresh grass and a fresh area. They have a nice little tarp for weather protection. And then when it starts to get a little chilly outside, we'll go ahead and put some hay in there for them as well. So today our chickens are 4 weeks old, and I'm going to take you out to do our morning chores. So we will fill our buckets with grain to take to our chickens, and then we're going to move our schooner and get them settled in for the day before we do other projects. So these are 10-ton grain bins, and we have two of them filled with our broiler ration. And so the way we get feed from our bins out to our chickens is that we fill up 5-gallon buckets and haul them out there with our UTV or on a trailer. And so we just simply put our bucket on the hanger, lift up the door, and fill our bucket. We fill the bucket up to a certain height, and then that way we know that it weighs 25 pounds. So we are getting ready to start our morning chores, and that involves bringing our tractor down to our schooners, hooking each schooner up to that tractor and moving them individually. So one person is driving the tractor, and then there's one person or two people in the schooner. And when they're in the schooner, they'll either use a tarp or a feed bag or a shavings bag, just to have a little bit of noise and emotion in there, and that helps keep the chickens moving forward with the schooner as it's moving. And so those people that are in the schooner, their job is to keep those chickens going forward to the fresh grass. It's always good to have some signals with your tractor driver. So if the tractor needs to stop so that the chickens can catch up, they just put their hand up. Once we have reached all fresh grass and are off of yesterday's grass, and they just give that driver a thumbs up so the driver knows that they can stop and reverse and unhook the schooner and move on to the next. So the way our water system works is that we have a quick release unit connecting our hose that's out in the field to the hose that connects to our water system within the schooner, so that when we're getting ready to move our schooner, we can just simply quickly release the two. And then that way you're not dragging your hose behind the schooner. That could cause significant damage, and you go through a lot more hoses than you should. When we have temperatures that are going to be below freezing or close to freezing, we will go ahead and disconnect the waterers during our evening chores. That way none of our system becomes frozen throughout the night. So after we move the schooner, we will go back and we will bring our hose back to the schooner, rehook that up so that we can clean out those waterers. We will get our buckets of chicken feed and make sure each feeder within that schooner is filled to its capacity. And then we will walk around the schooner, make sure that there's no big holes or anything like that that the chickens can get out of. If there are, then we'll either fill those with a tarp or the feed bags or some hay so the chickens stay in the schooner.
So with our water bowls and each schooner, after that we move them, we take the water bowl and we'll swish it around and dump that water out. And then we'll use our scrub brush and just simply scrub on the inside of it so that we can get all the grime and food that has washed off the chickens' beaks out of there so they have access to fresh water. So we bring our record from the brooder and we bring it out to the pasture, so it's in each schooner. We are still keeping track of how many mortalities that we have and then how much feed that we feed each schooner of chickens. And so we had 0 mortalities today, and we fed 5 buckets to our chickens. As you're moving throughout your pasture, the terrain is more than likely going to change. And so we always come inside before we fill the feeders with grain. We make sure that the feeders are at the appropriate height. We talked a couple times already that you want the rim of your feeder to be at the chicken's shoulders. Well, as you can see, these chickens walking around, they can actually walk underneath the feeder because we have a little bit of a dip going through our schooner. So we just simply use our S-hook that's on here and we lower it to where it will be at the chicken's shoulders so that it can eat at the proper height. With this dip that's going through our schooner, there's a little bit of mud, a little bit of water sitting on the ground. And so we are gonna go ahead and just grab a few handfuls of hay and cover this area so that the chickens don't get all muddy, so they can stay warm since the temperature today isn't going to be very high. In each schooner, we have a 30-foot piece of just plastic drainage tile, and we have on one side of each schooner, we just simply attach it with a few bungee cords. And the reason why we have this in here is so that when we get to the end of our pasture, and we need to turn around, we can simply just start turning our schooner at an angle, and this prevents the chickens from getting close to that bar and potentially getting some of their toes or their feet caught underneath there. When it goes against some of the woody plants, it's actually kind of nice because it makes a noise that prevents the chickens and it keeps the chickens away from that side that's turning. During our chores, we also really want to pay attention to the chickens' behavior, how they're acting, and how they look. If you take a look at these chickens, you can see that their feathers are a little ruffled up. It's cold here today, but it's a beautiful sunny day, no wind. And so we raised our flap on the south side so that the chickens can have access to the sunshine. And you can see majority of them have started to come over here into the sun so they can get warm and lay down. When it is also cold like this, we go ahead and put some hay on the ground so they can get in there and get warm with that. If it was going to be windy or raining or anything like that, then we would leave the sides down and still put hay out for them. So as you can see behind me, we have 2 of our schooners running side by side, but you can notice that there's a large space in between them, and we do that on purpose. If you remember, our schooners are 20 by 40, and so we want the space in between our schooners to be at least 20 feet so that when we get to the end of our pasture and we need to turn back around, that there's enough free, fresh grass in between schooners for one of them to come along there. And then the other schooner will just go off to the side. So we just placed this hay bale here a few days ago, and we placed it just in front of the schooners and in between 2 of them, so that when we do have to put out hay, we're close to 2 schooners at the same time, and it just makes putting out hay more efficient, and then we have to walk less. So we are at one of the last steps of our chicken batch. I'm going to walk you through how we prepare to get our chickens ready for processing, how we load them, and then what we do afterwards. So we load up our birds into crates and take them to the processor the day before their scheduled date for processing, because they will start very early in the morning with that. So at least 12 to 18 hours before the chickens are scheduled to be processed, we will take away their feeders so that we want their intestinal system to be clean of food. That will help decrease the number that will be condemned due to contamination. And then so we want them to keep fresh water around, but no access to feed. And so we'll take all the feeders away, give the feed to the other chickens of other batches, and wash those feeders so that they are clean for the next batch. To get ready for processing, we'll have all of our yellow crates here on the farm for the number of birds that we'll need. We do 7 to 8 birds per crate depending on how big they are. And then at nighttime, so after the sun is set, the chickens will be going to sleep. They'll be nice and calm. It'll be a less stressful environment for them. We will put all of the crates out around the schooner. And so I'll walk you through how we load our birds, and then maybe another scenario depending on what will work best for you. So with our schooners, the wood base at each end, we can remove those. And so what we have been doing is taking our yellow crates, putting them around the edge of the schooner. We will take off those wood ends, and we can pull our schooner over top of our chickens so that the chickens are just free where the schooner was, but they are still contained in the yellow crate wall. And then we have open space to catch the birds. We can walk in there without having to worry about the waters or the metal poles inside the schooners. And so we will take the yellow crates, and you want to take your crate to your chickens rather than bring your chickens to the crates. It'll be way more efficient, less walking on your part. You'll be able to just stand in one spot and pivot back and forth with chickens in your hand, putting them in the crates. So that's how we do it. Another way that you could do it would be that you take your crates inside whatever chicken schooner or tractor that you're using, and you can use those crates to make smaller sections so that the birds have less room to walk away from you, to move. That'll make it more efficient for you just to take the birds and put them into the crates. Your crates will be nice and close. But if you have another way that works best for you, you just want to make sure that it's efficient, it's less stressful for your chickens, and that it's just a safe environment for everybody. So these are the yellow chicken crates we use for the adult birds going to processing. We will put 7 to 8 birds in here depending on how big they are. And just for demonstration purposes, I will show you with these few chickens that we saved over from our last batch. We want our new livestock guardian dogs to still interact and be around poultry for the winter time. So we just saved these birds behind so that the dogs will have some poultry to be around. And so we do this at nighttime, like I said, after the sun has set. Depending on what the moon is like, it's going to be pretty dark out there. And so when you use headlamps, you want to make sure that the color of your light is either red or green. We don't want the white light to be on the chickens. And so when you're taking your chickens to processing, just as a precaution on your part, you want to make sure that you mark your crates, because you're probably not going to be the only one processing that day. So we just use simple flagging tape. We use the same color each time so the processor knows that pink tape belongs to Heifer Ranch. We just mark each crate on the end so that when they're unloading, they see which crates belong to us. And so these crates have a nice hinge door on top, so we have that open. And then, like I said earlier, you want to make sure that your crate is by your chickens. You don't want to go pick up a chicken and walk them back to your crate. You want to take your crate to your chickens. And so the way that we catch birds, you want this to be as less stressful as possible. So make sure you have gloves on. And you're going to take your hands and you're going to put them over top of the chicken's wings so that they don't start flapping. If they do start flapping, then that could cause some bruising, and then that would affect your end product. So we'll put our hands over top of the chicken wings, and then I catch their legs or their drumsticks in between my pinky finger and my ring finger just to help contain them and to have them move the least as possible. And so with your chickens, since you're putting multiple chickens in the crate, you want to make sure that you put your chickens inside of the crate so that when you get to your number 6 or 7 or 8, that you're not just piling your chickens on top of each other, so that there's room for everybody in there and they're not scratching each other's backs. So once your crate is full with a number of birds you want to put in there, you take your crate to the trailer, and we always make sure that there's two people carrying a crate because they get very heavy with 7 or 8 birds in there. So each person will be on the end. You'll go and you put it on your crate, and then these crates are really cool that they actually lock into place on top of each other. So you just want to make sure that you hear that clicking noise. And then as you're putting full crates of birds on top of each other, always listen and pay attention to the noises of the chickens, because there's some big slats on the floor of these crates that every once in a while a chicken may have their toe curled under there. And so if they start squawking or making a lot of noise, just simply lift those crates up so they can get their toes out of there. So we have officially entered our winter mode. We have sent off our last batch of poultry for the year. And so we have our schooners behind us that are ready for winter. We took the white tarps off the top so that we could put them in storage so that they're out of the sun, out of the wind, and that just helps keep them able to be used for longer. We'll get a couple years out of them. We'll take the watering system out, put that in storage. We'll clean all of the feeders and waterers, put those up out of the way. We'll pick up all of our water hoses out of the pasture just so everything stays nice out of the weather, just to get as much life out of it as we possibly can. We parked all of our schooners out of the way in the edge of the pasture so we can still graze other livestock through here and that they're not in the way of anything. Some other winter projects we'll be doing will be taking soil samples from pastures that poultry have been on and potential pastures that we need to put poultry on, just so that we know where our soil activity is at. We'll also be reviewing our chicken records that we kept throughout the year so we know how much input we put into them and how much profit we'll be making off of them. Throughout the year, our schooners go through a lot of wear and tear. So one of our winter projects will actually be going through the schooners, making sure all the wires connected, fixing anything that's broken. For example, here, this end bar got bent getting pulled through some tall grass. So that'll be one of the very first repairs we make before the start of the next season.